They've been talking the talk. It's now time to walk the walk. This is the Lighthouse Theater. I'm Todd Grisham. Next to me is Johnny Nelson.
Todd, it's going to be an amazing night. As per usual, everybody's going to benefit.
And now it's time for the tale of the tape. Joe Calzaghe, 6 foot even, with a weight of 174 pounds. His reach is 73 inches. And the man he'll be facing, it's Roy Jones Jr., 180 centimeters tall with 188 centimeter reach.
Nobody knows who's going to win. You can have an argument for the winner on both sides.
Here comes the Pride of Wales, a two-weight world champion who was never beaten. A legendary battle with Roy Jones Jr. as well. It's going to take something special to knock this man off his perch.
Roy. This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Fighting out of the red corner, presenting the...
Not too many seats to be had in this arena as the hype continues to build for this showdown.
This is going to be that fight.
These athletes have promised us a war. Let's see if they deliver. No stamina, no injury, but still throwing punches. Good counter punch. Punching. Oh, that punch. And that's exactly where he doesn't need to be. Does he have what it takes to get out of trouble here? And apparently no rest for the weary. Thought about taking a breath, but instead, they're in there throwing bombs again. He misses with that jab. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. A lot of respect in the ring from both of these fighters as they meet again. Calzaghe calls Jones one of the best fighters he's ever met. Even though it looks like we're going to see an early night here, he is rocked. He's trying to fight his way back into this. I don't know what his game plan is or if he's even got one. And now they're right back into the fray. Defend yourself at all times, but this fighter hasn't defended themselves at all. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. And the referee is right there, getting closer and closer to stopping this fight. Pretty dominant round there. Let's see how they respond here in the next round.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolute uproar.
Here we go, round two. Who's going to land the first big knockdown hard? I'm not sure that they're going to be able to get back on their feet here as the referee continues the count.
Two, three, four, five.
So they'll make it up and this fight continues. Back up on their feet, but I'm not sure why. Both
men step back for just a moment.
God, we see much, much more, much, much better. We've been spoiled. I'm not being unfair since it's a little boring. It's not boring, we've probably just been spoiled.
Welcome inside this unique environment, a beautiful theater, ready for a fist fight.
Todd, I've got to give it to the promoter. To pick this place, every ticket is like gold dust. You cannot get these tickets. So if you are in this venue, you are watching this fight, trust me, we're lucky to be sat here.
So final 10 seconds of the round, and he is looking really sharp. The corner hasn't thrown in the towel yet, so I guess he's coming out for another round.
They believe their fighter has it in the tank.
And that'll do it for the time between rounds as we get set to get back in the action. Here we go in round three. Who's going to land the first big shot? Is this the beginning of the end after two knockdowns last round?
I have no idea what they have left. What? How? How do you come back from something like that? Knocked down twice? Where's your head at? Where's your energy levels at? It tells you you've got nothing left.
And he misses with that jab. He got out of the way of that right hook. Good counter punching from both these fighters. Nice counter shot. He caught him clean. Is this the beginning of the end? Being shown here, but he needs more than that to survive the round. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. A true champion knows how to get out of trouble after they got into trouble, and that's what he's doing here.
It's been a tough round so far. It's been a tough, tough round. What did they do? What did they tell him when he goes back to the corner? How are they going to get through this?
Keep an eye on this slugger. As you know, he's willing to take three to give one. That's his game plan, and it's worked out pretty well for him so far.
They've got to be very wary. If you're in with a slugger, they will fight all night for fun. They'll stay in your face. They are naturally tough and strong and aggressive.
This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. No secret who has the advantage after that last round. Let's see what they have in store for us in the next one.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter. And the corner man's got to put a firecracker on the fighter. Get out there and get the job done.
On to the fourth we go. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round.
Five, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
some point, the corner may have to intervene here because this fighter won't stay down. You couldn't write a script like this. This is like Rocky versus Apollo. Many people would have predicted it, but we've got a knockout victory.
Accuracy, power, punch, perfect. That must hurt.